Hello, hello everyone. I am Dr. Supreet. I am here to share you one of the topic from the subject Design for the Safety and Comfort, whose subject code is AEA441. I am from the Department of Automobile Engineering, and today I would like to share the chapter that is Unit 1, Design of Automotive Body and Safety. In the Automotive Body and Safety, automobile engineering student will be learning, understanding the engineering principle and design of an automobile for the safety and comfort. They will be understanding the design for the automotive body and safety. They will be understanding the vehicle structure and the crash energy management, gain knowledge about the automotive safety system, understanding the convenience system, understanding the comfort system in an automotive, whether it is in car, whether it is in truck. Student, you have been seeing that the safety and the comfort are the two features which are priority for the driver and the passenger. So we will be covering up that how that safety and design are priorities and how they are installed, what are their mechanisms, how they work, what are the various devices which has been applied onto an automotive vehicle so that it provide a safety and comfort. So let us start. We will be covering up the content in that is introduction, that what is the design and the safety. Design of a vehicle body and safety, that how vehicle body is designed, what are the various safety devices. Design of the classification of the design structure, that is active and passive safety devices. Necessary features of the vehicle safety body, that what are the features if we install the various active and passive devices, what are the safety features which they give. Designing technique and strategies. Engine location, where the engine is located, basically it is located in front, mid and rear. So what are their positioning, which is the most safe for one. Material selection for the design of the vehicle safety. Concept of the crumble zone. What is crumble zone? That where the steel bars have been installed in the front and the rear, which provides the safety during an accident to the passenger or the driver. So safety sandwich constructions. What are the various sandwiches which has been produced in the automotive that which provide the material strength? So that safety sandwich construction will be discussed in this slide of the Unit 1, Chapter 1. Let us proceed. What is automobile safety first of all? You can see in this diagram that this is a car in which we have installed various safety devices and various comfort devices. So let us discuss that what is safety and what is comfort, what is the difference in that. Automobile safety is the study and the practice of the design, construction, equipment and the regulation to minimize the occurrence and consequence of automobile accidents. We install various safety devices in the automobile in order to provide during the accident that there is no harm to the passenger or the driver. So we provide the safety devices. Comfort. When we talk about the comfort, we want that the passenger is paying a good money to buy a car. So he wants comfort while sitting in the car, while driving, and also when he gets some accident, then there is an ease of the passenger to come out of the car, whether it is a very cumbersome and the locked situation, still the customer can come out of the car. So next is road traffic safety more broadly includes the road design and also ease for the user or the driving while vehicle. So there are some of the signals which are on the road which has been detected by the car due to installation of few sensor in that is road safety sensors. It will detect that and it will move accordingly whether the user or the driver has not seen the signals or not. Next, automotive safety is the necessity of today's fast life generation, one of the first formal academic study in improving the vehicle safety. So we all drive the cars, we all drive four wheelers, we all drive a commercial vehicle also is being driven. So the foremost is safety, comfort is the second part. So let us discuss the features. First of all, we define the classification of automotive system in active and passive safety systems. So let us see what are active automotive safety system and what is passive safety system. It is in the car only, though it is in the commercial vehicle also, but we will be discussing in the four-wheeler car only. Let us see. So what is active safety system? Active safety system play a vital role in the which are being installed in the car, which are helpful to us to avoid the accidents. How I can explain you that whenever you can see the, there is for example, just cite an example to explain what I am going to cover in this slide. So we are traveling on a road, and say some pedestrian is coming and we are busy in some mobile phone or some activity or talking to the co-passenger, we are not able to see that pedestrian. At that time, one of the sensor will act, that is the pedestrian has been detected by the sensor of the vehicle, and it will apply the automatic brake because we haven't applied the brake to the vehicle. So this is the safety device. So let us cover. Term suggests as the play a preventive role in mitigating the crashes, accident by providing the advance warning to the driver with the additional assistance in the steering and control up of the vehicle. Let us start one by one. Head-up display. Head-up display is a later, it is in the Mercedes, it is in the BMW's top model car. This feature has been introduced. There are certain features like in the head-up signal that if we are changing the gear, which gear has to be applied on which speed, that displays upon the windscreen of the car, on the windscreen. I am not talking about the cluster instrument that is the on the dashboard, that or not that, on the windscreen. So that is the head-up display. Next is, in the head-up display we can avoid, why we do this? We do this because in the head-up display there is a lot of the accidents. In order to avoid the accidents, we use the head-up display. So second one is the anti-lock braking system. Anti-lock braking system, it is usually in all the cars. Whenever there is a muddy road, there is a rainy road, or there is a gravel on the roads, so the continuous brake is being applied by the user, but what signal is sent by the ABS, that it applies in the millis of seconds. The brake up, then continuous. The continuous braking is braked up, or we can say there is a halt in braking in milliseconds in order to avoid the skidding of the vehicle. So it also avoids the accident. Or I can say if a truck is standing, say, nearly 20 feet far from your car, and you are driving very fast, and there is a muddy road, you suddenly apply the brake, but that ABS will not allow to strike in that, and it you can easily change your steering direction. So ABS will help in that. Next is electronic control stability. It is the sensor drive steering. Put the internal, for example, you want that your car is moving on a bumpy road, or we can say on a curvy road. So at that time, electronic stability control will apply the pressure on the internal tires in order to make the less distance to be covered by the internal wheels. So it is very helpful in providing the stability. So that is also done by the ECU system, controlled by the ECU system. Tire pressure monitoring system. In the tire pressure monitoring system, the all the four tires which has been installed on the car, we are able to see that what is the pressure in the what is the pressure in the tire. So that display of the pressure will just a warning signal. It will not fill the air. It will help the user to know that what is the amount of the filled air in the tire. So the internal this will help only in the, this will provide on the it can provide on the windscreen also, that is the head-up display. It can provide on the it can provide the display on the instrument cluster also, that is near the dashboard, on the dashboard. Lane departure warning system. You must have seen when you drive the vehicle on the car, the vehicle on the road, what happened, that due to a high pressure, sometimes the vehicle try to change its path. Or second case is that when it is having an uneven road, So vehicle tried to change its path. So lane departure warning is just provide a warning signal on the top of the instrumental cluster that your lane is being changed. Either you try to maintain the lane. If you will not do twice or thrice, it will continuously wobble the steering, that we get a signal that we should not change the lane. Next is adaptive cruise control system. Let us understand what is a cruise control system. Say my vehicle is moving at 100 km per hour, or say with 150 miles per hour. So at that time, the road is totally vacant. I'm driving the vehicle and road is totally vacant. I want that my vehicle should move continuously, but I do not apply any I should not apply any my foot on the accelerator. So I just press the cruise control button, that my vehicle last speed will be say 100 km per hour or 150 miles per hour, whatsoever is the speed of my vehicle. So it will move continuously. It will move continuously after you will apply the cruise button, though you have put up your feet back from the accelerator. Remember one thing, the cruise control system will cut up. Cruise control system will cut up whenever you again press upon the accelerator button, brake or clutch, whatever you will press, the cruise control will be cut up. And now our topic is adaptive cruise control system. What is that? In the adaptive cruise control system, say you were in the cruise control system, what you have done that you have applied the cruise system and it is moving continuously with the 100 km per hour. You are not applying any brakes, but suddenly a truck come in between from a sideway or the bypass lane. At that time, what happens? Your vehicle was at 100, but truck was at 30 km per hour. So at that time, your adaptive cruise control system will automatically make your vehicle to drive by 30 km per hour. So what happened at that time? That adaptive cruise control system helped the vehicle to redesign its speed, that is from 100 to 30. You haven't done anything, you were sitting idle in the car, but adaptive cruise control system helped to control the car. But remember this thing, whenever you apply pedal, brake, clutch, the cruise control system will be cut out. Next is your driver monitoring system. In the driver monitoring system, what happened? That driver is continuously monitored. For example, if you get to sleep in the car, there is a vibration on the steering vehicle and you will wake up. So when two or three times you are not able to wake up, it will get automatically shut off. Blind spot detection. Next is blind spot detection. Usually in the long vehicle you have seen, we are not able, whenever we take a turn, we are not able to see some of the parts of in the outside the vehicle. So what at on the road also we are not able. So we have fixed the cameras. On the cameras display is on the inside of the cabin, so we can see the blind spot detection through a camera. So night version system, in the night, usually it is in the rainy or in the foggy day, what happened that you are not able to see what is what if there's stray animal or any vehicle standing on the road. So this system will able to give a detection on the road that there is some animal or a standing vehicle or vehicle in forward of your driving vehicle. So are the common active system device. So these basically help us in order to avoid the accident, that before the accident occurs, in order to avoid that there is no accident on the vehicle. So this complete diagram is showing the same active system on the board, environment, driver, road, vehicle. So it provide a cyclic process between road, driver, environment, and basically vehicle. Let us move forward to the next slide. So this I have already explained you. Anti-lock braking system, traction control system. What is traction control system? The tires on the muddy road basically gets a slip. So in order to provide a continuous braking, there is a traction on the road. So that traction control system sends the signal to ECU and that braking is applied in order to provide the traction. Stability control system I have already explained, which does not, when during a curvy road there is we require any strength to the vehicle, or the internal tires is having braking, or the internal tire is getting some pressure, so we apply the stability. cruise control, I have explained, steering control, suspension control. What is suspension control? There is a lot of bumps on the road. Then the vehicle the hydraulic fuel of the vehicle get viscous. When it get viscous, so whenever there is a bump, due to the viscous oil, the bump is less transferred to the vehicle. So next is intelligence speed assistance. In the intelligence speed system, it is very easy that you detect that whenever there is the vehicle want that it is increasing the speed, or the vehicle require more speed according to the increased in the mileage, we require intelligence speed assistance. So blind spot, I have covered. Light source recognition, whenever is a we turn the vehicle, there is a light, the light is turned according to our turn, that is light source, lane departure warning, that whenever you are changing the lane. So these are things which we have already covered, I have explained you in the last slide. So this is the explanation in words. Students, if you want to, which I have explained, if you are not able to listen carefully, you are not able to understand, I have kept in a text form, you can also read this. This I have explained you all. Let us come to the passive safety system. In the passive safety system, it is the system whenever the accident occurs. When the accident occurs, now what are the safety devices which has to be installed in order to provide safety to you, in order to provide, in order so that there is no serious injury to your body. It should not come to the death of the passenger or the driver. So what is that? Passive system play important role in limiting or containing the damage injuries caused to the driver, passengers, pedestrian in the event of the crash or accident. So it is clear, the active system act tell us the warning signal so that accident should not occur. But if the accident is occurring, that is the passive safety system will help you. So let us understand. Airbags. So I will explain each and every part also. Airbags, you know, but there is a very variety of classification in airbags also. Seat belts, we will cover this, don't worry. Whiplash protection system, common passive system deployed in these days. Let us understand, because I have put up in the theory part also, I'll explain it through diagrammatically. It will be very easy for you. Let us start. Airbags, if I say. So students, what come in your mind, that whenever a vehicle strike to some high momentum body or some standing body, the dashboard crash up and the airbags come on to you. But there is a lot of variety in airbags. What is that? We are having front airbags. That is, front airbags is in the front of the bumper for the pedestrian safety. You can see this type of features in Mercedes, BMWs, in higher model car, Rolls Royce. So this type of airbags are there for the pedestrian safety. Next is the side airbags. The side airbags is for the passenger. Sometimes there is a strike from the side of the vehicle, so that is safety for the passenger from the side. Similarly, from the front, if it is the vehicle is hit from the front, so the dashboard crash up and the airbags come on to the safety of the driver and the co-passenger. So and also the rear one, side one, front one, and for the pedestrian, that is the outer body of the car. So in the airbags, I would like to add one more thing, that there is nitrogen filled in the airbags. This gas is common, which is filled. And also I would like to mention one thing, in the passive safety devices, the airbags whenever get inflated in the modern cars, it see that what is the weight of the passenger. If the passenger is very fatty, and airbag will also inflate, and it can also provide a inhaling problem for the, and it can choke the breath of the we can say passenger or the driver. So it also detect the weight on the seat belt, on the your seat. So airbags have very vast study in this. I'll be covering a very short topic in this. So I am not miss any point if I would like to say it has nitrogen filled in that. It has from rear, front, from the outside, from the sides of the airbags. And moreover, most important thing, that airbag inflate according to the airbag inflate according to the passenger sitting on the, where it is a small child, it will inflate according to the child. So seat belts, next is the seat belt. Seat belt, it just when we pull up and we pull the buckle into the tongue into the buckle, and it we get the safety, the whenever there is a hit, passenger does not come out of the vehicle. Whiplash protection system. What is whiplash protection system? If a car is hit very strongly from the front side, so the head of the vehicle, sometimes goes back with very strong strength. So the whiplash protection system provides the strengthening to your back, so that there is no problem of the to your neck. There is no neck breakage or no injury to the head. Let us cover through the diagram. So you can clearly see the side airbag we have already covered. The rear crumple zone. What is crumple zone? I would like to introduce that, the new term, crumple zone. Crumple is basically a strong energy absorbing steel bars. It may be of aluminium also, designed upon the vehicle. It is changing its material. So cross car beak for the side impact. So you can clearly see the crumples, the rear crumples. It is an energy absorbing steel bars or the aluminium bars. Whenever the vehicle is strike from the top or from the back, these energy absorbing crumples will absorb the energy and will not allow the engine to come in speed, safety to the vehicle. Clear? So these crumples and energy absorbing bumper mounts. So it is clear, front crumpler zones, rear crumpler zones. So it is, I guess, clear in this diagram. Next, I come to the picture is a bit not clear, so I'm using the laptop to see the side airbag we have covered. Padded instrument panel. This is padded instrument panel. What is that? Whenever there is a strike, the material is of composite material, it should not crash into pieces. Laminated windshield. What is laminated windshield? It is in all the vehicles nowadays, that whenever there is strike on the windscreen, it will not break into pieces. Understand? It will not break into pieces. It will have a crack, or it will just have a number of cracks on the top surface, but it will not break into pieces and fall onto the user. So high strength steel safety case surrounding passenger. It is a monocoque construction also, and the uni construction also on the chassis. So it provides the strength to the top of the vehicle. You can clearly see whenever your vehicle get turned out onto the road due to some accident, this provides the strength that does not allow your head to get injured. So next is your child safety seat, complete safety belts. You can see here, this a child is sitting, a small baby boy is sitting, a very cute baby boy is sitting. So he is having a seat belt, he is having a seat in which there are safety devices for him also. Minor door hinges and side guard door beams. Side guard door beams is basically providing the strength when the vehicle is strike from this backwards. So I think I have covered all the things. If I'm not missing, diagnostic module is left. Diagnostic module. This diagnostic module is sensing the problems, tire pressure, fuel is whether less or not, whether the vehicle driver is wearing the belt or not. There are various number of problems which occurs during the driving also, during the initiation also, that is covered by the diagnostic module. So I think I have covered all the laminated windscreen, front impact sensor, this one. So this was all about the passive safety devices. I have also inserted in the text part also, occupant sensing system. The sensor will detect who is sitting, and occupant sensing eliminate the need or on off of the switchbacks in most cases. In the case co-passenger is not sitting, but accident occurs, but the co-passenger part airbag will not get opened. So I have covered this part also with you earlier. Whiplash provide the head protection. Child safety system design that protect the child from the injury, which is covered. Pedestrian safety, I already told you, whenever you strike the vehicle with a pedestrian, airbag open from outside. Also there are devices which provide automatically braking to the vehicle also, in order to get accident with the pedestrian. So design of the safety of the vehicle. So I would like to end up the video over here. It is just a part one. In this, how I would like to end that there is a space ease for space ease and the comfort for the passengers. Their aerodynamic design in order to provide the safety to the vehicle and a high mileage. And the design should be like that the collision should take place should not absorb all the impact on the vehicle. Whenever there is an accident, the most safe vehicle will that if the passengers and the driver will not be affected. That all the your crumpler zone, the energy absorbing your steel bars or the aluminium bar will absorb the energy, not allow the engine to come inside. Or sometimes this also case I have seen on the YouTube videos that steering system, the rod also is being hit up on the face or the head of the driver. So this steering vehicle bar also move downwards sometimes. This is also safety features. So I'll go that in the next videos in that in detail. So vehicle body structure is subjected to static and dynamic service loads during the life cycle. It has to be maintain its integrity and provide the adequate protection in the survival cases. Last one is that it is continuously, if you want, all the safety devices and the comfort devices is installed on the vehicle. So it provide the strength to the vehicle. And students, you can, there is a lot of things to learn in the active and passive classification of the safety and comfort zone. I will also add one of my practical safety feature added in the vehicle. I have patented that file. I will add this with this video. I will add a 2-minute short clip for what we have patented. I would like to just describe in brief. We have me and my student and master student has designed a tire that is a whip gear tire. In that we are providing that the whip gear tire, the layered top layer to the top surface of the tire, and whenever the vehicle will move on the road, one of the layer out of that violet, indigo, blue, yellow, orange, that layer, one of that will be, that is 2 centimeter layer, which will be eradicated while the wear on the tire. So whenever the user will buy an old car or an old tire, by seeing that measurement, user can easily see that how much tire is worn out. So we have patented that. I will add a short video of design and safety, which the patent we have done last year. In this video also, I'll explain that. So thank you, students. This was just a topic one of the unit one, that is active and passive safety devices and introduction to design of safety and control. We have further more many topics to discuss. We will go in the next video. Thank you, students.